हेलो एवरीवन, सो वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल कोडिंग फॉर ऑल। सो गाइस, टुडे व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट प्रॉब्लम व्हिच इज़ गोइंग टू कम इन योर इंटरव्यूज मोस्ट प्रोबेबली। एंड द प्रॉब्लम नेम सेज इज मैक्सिमम प्रोडक्ट सब अरे। सो अर्लियर इन दिस सीरीज और माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज ए सब अरे। ओके, सो आई हैव डिस्कस अबाउट सब अरे इज अ स्निपिट which we take out from the our array without breaking in between. So when I say I am taking this snippet, so this can be called as a subarray because I am not breaking in between. If I take minus two here, then I am breaking in between, so it is not a subarray. So you know the concept of subarrays. Now the question is finding maximum product subarray in an array. So how we are going to do this question? The thing is that the brute force solution of this question is very simple. What you can do is you can generate all the possible subarrays within the arrays, and you can find the maximum of all the subarrays. So what I'm telling here is you can use two for loops, one for loop within another for loop. You can start from here and you can take this. So these are all the subarrays starting at -2. And you can find the product of them, and you can store a maximum variable somewhere, and then you iterate over here. So you start from here, so you calculate all the subarrays from this point, then this point. So this solution takes big of n square because there would be two for loops in this solution. So in my opinion, or it is not an efficient solution, I can say it is not efficient because it is taking n square time complexity. For smaller arrays it would be nice, but when the input size grows, then I don't think so this solution would work. So what we need to think here is we should come out with a solution which would run in linear time, like big of n time complexity. Okay, so how we are going to do it? The way which we are going to use here is cadence algorithm, guys. So I think if you have seen my previous videos where I have discussed about cadence algorithm, so you know the fact that how you can linearly traverse an array, and you can find the you can already find the maximum product array or maximum sum in an array, right? So cadence algorithm we are going to use. Now I am going to write the algorithm and you can just follow, and just don't leave the video in between, because if you are leaving in between, you won't understand anything. So guys, here I have written the code. So finding the maximum product subarray, the important thing we need to understand is we need to maintain two variables. Two important variables are minimum product and maximum product. So why we are using minimum product and maximum product, these two variables? The first variable, minimum product, which we are going to use is because it can happen that the previous element would be -3, and the second element which we get is -2. For the first case, you can see that first element we are getting is -2, after that we are getting -3. So when minus and minus elements are multiply each other, they can possibly give you a large number like 6. So what we need to understand is we have to have minimum product as our variable and maximum product. So we are using concept of dynamic programming. Dynamic programming tells us to divide our main problem into smaller sub problems. Okay, so how we are going to divide this problem? We are going to find the maximum product sub array and minimum product possible at particular index ending. So here I am going to say at 0th index, minimum product I am going to find, and maximum product I am going to find. I will move ahead, and at this index also I am going to find what is the minimum product possible ending at this index, what is the maximum product possible ending at this index by this sum. Okay, and our result will be stored in maximum sum variable. Okay, so how we are going to do this? Now I have stored a of 0 and a of 0 in two variables. Okay, so what we are going to do here is this is initialized with minus 2 here, okay, minus 2, because till now, till zeroth index, minimum product which we have, we can generate is minus 2, maximum product also minus 2, because we have not traversing till now. Now, after storing these elements, what we are going, we are iterating starting from 1, like here, from here we are going to iterate over the array, and we are going to do this, max product would be maximum of something, min product would be minimum of something, like this. Okay, so what is this max and what is in this thing? Okay, so we have three choices. Okay, every single time to choose maximum product or minimum product, we have three choices. One choice would be the array element. What I can say, an array element, array element. Suppose we are at ith index, and the possibility of having ith index as maximum or minimum is very much. Suppose there is minus 300 on particular index, so it can be counted as minimum product possible. If it is 500 plus 500, I can say that this this element, array element, is my maximum sum. So this can be one possibility, array of I. Okay, second possibility is we can multiply this array element, this array element, with minimum product which is we got. And another possibility is we are multiplying this element with maximum product we can got. Okay, so this I'm going to explain now, and after this we are going to compare maximum product and minimum product, and maximum of all the iteration, after the iteration, what is the maximum would be stored in maxsum. So I'm going to discuss about how these two functions are working. Okay, what is this? I'm going to discuss now. Yes, I have created a table now. So what I've said is you have three choices to choose minimum product as well as maximum product. Okay, so how you are going to choose minimum product and maximum product? First choice would be A of I, like array element you can choose as a minimum or maximum product. Second would be A of I multiplied by minimum product till then, and A of I into max product. So you are going to understand it now. What we are doing is at 0th index, A of I is minus 2, minimum product is minus 2, and maximum product is minus 2. I already discussed how it is minus 2. We are initiating minimum product as well as maximum product as A of 0. Because 0th index, we have these choices. We have this. So this is the thing. In second iteration, on first index, what we have is we can either choose minus 3, minus 3, minimum product would be, minimum product would be, we have three choices for minimum product. One choice would be minus 3, one choice would be minus 3 multiplied by minus 2, and minus 3 multiplied by minus 2. Okay. So this is minus 3 we can take as a minimum product. We can take A of I into minimum product, which is minus 3 into minus 2, 6, or maximum product is minus 3 into minus 2, which is 6. So how we are going to take, out of these three, we are going to choose minimum as well as maximum product. So minimum would be minus 3 and maximum would be 6. So max product, this would be 6 and this would be minus 3 up to now. Okay, minus 3. Now we go to third index. Okay, 0, 1, 2, second index. Now we say we can take 0 or 0 multiplied by minus 3 or 0 multiplied by 6. So in all the cases, we are going to get 0 only. Whenever you multiply 0 with any of these, like 6, you can multiply 6 into 0 or minus 3 into 0, you are going to get 0. So at this point, what happened is you have to take minimum of this and maximum of this, which would be 0 and 0. Minimum would be 0, like this. So at this step, what happened is minimum product which can be possible up to this index is 0, and maximum also will be 0. Okay, now at 0 minus 2 we reach here. What happens is you can take minus 2, you can take minus 2 into 0, okay, like this, or you can take minus 2 into 0. Okay, so when you choose in between, the minimum product which up to this index would be minus 2, because when you say minus 2, 0 and 0, minimum of this is minus 2. And when you say maximum, so you get max product would be 0. So what I'm saying, up to this index, you have two choices for this. Your this minimum product would become minus 2 and this would become 0. Now, at last index, minus 40 would be the array element. So at fourth index, what we are going to do, we are going to take minus 40. We have three choices. Remember, always remember three choices. First is minus 40. Second would be minus 40 into minimum product. So minus 40 into minus 2, which is minimum product till now. And maximum would be minus 40 or 0. So these are the choices. So what we are going to get here, 80, here 0 and 0. So when we take 80 out of this, because this is minimum product, so minimum this will be 80. Okay, so when we do this thing, so we get 80 as answer. And on last step, what we are going to do, max sum would be equals to max. The step you remember, last step was, after writing this every single time, what we are going to do is, like 80 would be the thing. So what we do is, we say max of min product and max product. Okay, so here min product would be 80 and max product would be 0. So you choose 80 would be maximum. So this is how it works. This is very simple, but if you understand, it would be really simple for you. So once again, I am giving the summary of this video. At every index, at 0th, 1, 2nd, any index, you have to find two things: minimum product, possible ending up to that index, and max product. Okay, and you have to apply that function which I have told you, and you have to find, eventually you are going to find. The main thing to remember here is, we are maintaining two variables, one is min product and max product, and every single time choosing min product and max product, we have three choices. We can take array element also. We can multiply array element with previous min product, or array element multiplied by max product. So you are going to get this thing and your answer would be right. So in single traverser, you have got the answer. So time complexity would be big O of n, and it is very efficient solution for finding the maximum subarray, product subarray. So guys, that's it for this video. If you like my video, and if you know something, and if you understood this concept, then please like the video, share this video as much as possible, as well as subscribe to my channel. And till then, I'm going to meet you in my next video.